this shit. Are you guys drunk? You guys feeling good? Having a good time tonight, everybody? Yeah. That's what this tour is all about. Having fun. That's why we call it the Academic Probation Tour. It's because I was on academic probation in community college. So, I'm not kidding. So that showed you how good my life was going, and now I'm on a tour in front of a couple hundred people, so this is awesome. How's everybody doing though? Everyone doing good? All right, that is fantastic. This is the year anniversary show, man, so much crazy shit can happen. You guys don't even know. I might just bust out in random dance moves throughout this whole thing and you guys wouldn't even see it coming. You guys think I'm kidding, right? Sound guy, hit that shit.
Now watch me whip, now watch me nae-nae. Okay. Now watch me whip, watch me nae-nae. Now watch me whip, watch me nae-nae. Okay. Now watch me whip, watch me nae-nae.
Expect that shit, did you?
Woo-hoo!
Yeah. So whenever I think I'm losing you guys, I'm just gonna bust out in the random dance move to get you guys hyped up. I think about a lot of weird stuff, and this is one of the weirdest things I think of. Did you ever think how many animals did we had to jump on the backs of until we realized horses were cool with it? Like, that would be the shittiest job if you think about it. Like, imagine being the test dummy for that shit. I imagine it being like one of those shows on the Discovery Channel. It's just a drunk Australian guy, like off of Foster's. He's just hammered drunk. His one friend can't even hold the camera right, and it's just like on a handheld. He's like, Crikey, over here we have an ostrich. Let's go see if we could ride it. And then he goes, it doesn't work out. Did you ever see a fucking ostrich run? That is the funniest shit I've ever seen in my life. There's like, and then after that fails, he just like comes back. He's like, okay, Crikey, that was a bad one. Okay, over here we have a cheetah. Let's go see if we could ride this. Stay back. And then he runs, but it just runs away. And then the camera just falls down. He comes back. He's like, Crikey, that was a fast fucking animal. That's one of the fastest animals I've ever seen in my life. And then he's like, all right, for today's episode, this is the last one. Over here, brings out his fucking binoculars. Over here to the right, we got a fat hippo. Look at this. Wait, mate. That's just my wife. Never mind. We can't do this. We'll be back next week. I like, everyone was like, so, it's a joke, guys. Everyone's like, holy shit. There's no Australian guy filming this stuff who, like, calls his wife a hippo. But I just say that, I love animals because animals are so much like human beings nowadays. Like, they're smart, they're stupid, and they lost concentration, like, very quickly. Like, did you ever see a cat play with a toy? They're just, like, sitting there, they're like, and then, like, after, like, 2 minutes, they do that stupid blank stare, they're like, and then they just lose concentration. It's like, I think I thought of something. Never mind. And then they go back to playing with it. I always think that, like, animals are really smart. And I always thought to myself, do you think if a regular dog was just, like, getting walked down the street and he sees a canine coming out of the car, he's like, oh shit, it's the cops! And then he starts running the other way. And so, animals are just like so funny and they're so stupid like that. The one thing I hate about animals though is those SPCA commercials. Have you guys ever seen those things? Yeah. This dude's like, oh shit. It's the saddest shit I've ever seen in my life. Like, it can't just be like something like kosher, right? It's like a dog who has casts on all four of his legs. He's like trying to walk. Has like a chicken with a pencil in his eye. A fucking cat that's spray painted says pussy on the side. And it always comes like when you least expect it, right? So like a couple weeks ago, I was watching a comedy with my friends And it was a commercial break, so we're like, we're like in a good mood, we're laughing, and then that fucking song comes on. You guys know that song, right? In the arms of an angel. And next thing I know, there's a puppy looking straight at my eyes. And that was the first time in my life I had a single tear. It just dropped. I was like, this is the saddest thing I've ever seen in my life. But I'm a broke comedian, so I can't support these fuckers. And then after that, they play like a fucking Outback Steakhouse commercial. It's like, come here, Outback Steakhouse. Get a nice filet mignon for $4.99 and wash it down with a tall, cold Foster's. And then I'm like, I'm crying like in my eyes. I'm like, where'd you get that meat, you fucking bastard? Man, animals are so cool, but that shit just like pisses me off with that. did you guys watch the Super Bowl earlier this month? Anybody even give a shit about the Super Bowl? Everybody's answer. I watched it just for the statistics, not the in-game statistics. I read this article, I swear to God. It was on like USA Today or some shit. And since weed's been legal in Colorado, fights at the stadiums gone down 50%. And since Peyton Manning is a spokesperson for Papa John's, their pizza sales went up 80% from high people just satisfying their munchies from fucking weed. And I think to myself, I was like, what if we did that with Philly? But we're assholes. So if weed was legalized, we would still be getting in as like many fights as we want and cursing off any 12-year-old who's wearing the opposite team's jersey. Fucking pussy! Your dad's teaching you to be a bitch, son! Yo, I was at a Flyers game, I think like a year or two ago, right? It was Flyers versus Penguins. And there was these, it was a dad and a kid. The kid had to be like 10 years old, right? And I'm all good for fucking with people, I'm a comedian. But you know, there has to be a limit, okay? So, there's this kid walking, right? And he's walking with his dad, they're like holding hands. They're both wearing like matching Sidney Crosby jerseys. I'm like, you know, if we're in Pittsburgh, this would be cool, but I'm not gonna say anything, you know? And this one drunk guy, he goes up to the kid and he goes, hey, your dad's teaching you to grow up to be a pussy, you fucking loser. Why don't you get a Flyers jersey? I'm like, this kid's 12 years old and you just berate him. He probably doesn't know who the hell Sidney Crosby is. That shit was so disturbing. But I'm glad it's 2016 though. Did everyone else have a shitty 2015? Anybody in here? Yeah, that seemed to be the case, right? 2015 sucked, man. A lot of crazy shit happened in 2015. Let's take a recap down memory lane. One of the things that happened in 2015 was California. They were in this big rut. They lost a lot of trees and water supplies, which is horrible for the economic system. And then when they did some investigation and stuff, they realized the trees were gone because Snoop Dogg smoked all of them. And yeah, and he used the water for his bong and his cotton mouth. And then you guys remember that riot that happened in Baltimore, like Ferguson and shit like that? Yeah. The one thing I didn't get about that, like, if you're going to riot, you're going to riot. But they fucked up their only CVS that they had in that town. So nobody can get to prescriptions or tampons or condoms or, like, you know, Twix, whatever necessities that you need. And I was thinking to myself, I was like, that's if Delco, you know, went on, like, a big-ass, like, rant and shit like that. And we destroyed Wawa's. It makes no sense at all because 90% of Delco people thrive off of Wawa to like satisfy their needs. It doesn't make any sense. But they released, the only thing that was left was surveillance cameras. And the people who took out that CVS, they were Rite Aid workers. Yeah, they were in surveillance. They had like the blue, they had the blue vest on. The name tag, it said Jeff. The running hours shit. Like, now these fuckers are going to come at us tomorrow. Taken out to competition, throwing salt in the wound when they're down. It's kind of messed up, but you know, I would do the same thing. Get rich or die trying, that's what 50 Cent says, right? Another thing that happened in 2015 was, do you guys remember the Lamar Odom story? Anybody remember that? Yeah, this dude, whoever doesn't know who Lamar Odom is, he's a 7-foot-tall NBA superstar, right? And he goes to a bunny ranch in Vegas, And he spent $75,000 on prostitutes. $75,000, okay? And his night ended up getting short because he overdosed on cocaine and natural male enhancements. I'm not making this shit up. I've been around a lot of people that do drugs, and that is the weirdest combination of drugs I've ever heard of in my life. Cocaine and natural male enhancements. You would think because he's an athlete, you know, they're physically shaped, they work out all the time, that they would be fine. But one of the prostitutes is kind of messed up. She took a picture of him passed out naked in the bathroom because she was going to bribe him for more money, you know, because, you know, $75,000 wasn't enough for those fucking prostitutes. So they wanted to take it out, right? So when the cops got to the scene, the picture did release online. It was pretty freaking embarrassing. When they walked into the bathroom, this is what they saw. Yeah, it's disturbing, right? A 7-foot dude with a massive erection passed out in the bathroom. The cops had to use the jaws of life to get that shit out. Another thing that happened was Charlie Sheen got HIV. Let's be honest, Charlie Sheen didn't get HIV. HIV got Charlie Sheen because he's a goddamn saint. Okay? But are we really, like, surprised? This dude's fucked more prostitutes and did more blow than the rock stars nowadays. I'm surprised he's still alive. But he's been warning us for years. You guys just have to see the lines. He's like, I got tiger blood. I got tiger blood inside of me. Well, now we know what tiger blood is. It's fucking HIV. he's been warning us for years. Another thing that happened was, this is what I didn't get. Caitlyn Jenner got the Female of the Year award by Vogue magazine in New York City. I have three things wrong with that. Number one, she hasn't even been a female for a full year. So how does she get that title? They're like, no, she's a good girl. We're going to advance her a couple months and give her this shit. And then two, fuck you, America, okay? And three, that just proves men are better than women at everything, including being a woman. Oh my god, there's gonna be girls with like pitchforks out there when I'm done. That was a bad joke, I'm sorry. Everyone, that just got so silent. But since it is the New Year's though, New Year, New Me, that catchy phrase. The one big change I'm making in my life is I quit drinking. During the week, motherfuckers. Not full time. That shit is just nonsense. But I had to stop because, you know, it's just too much hassle. You know, hangovers are a thing nowadays. And I just did stupid shit when I was drunk, so I just can't deal with it anymore. But I read this. The one thing I do miss about getting, like, hammered was drunk munchies. You guys remember the drunk munchies? Yeah, everybody's like, yeah, fuck yeah. Like, you look forward to drunk munchies more than, like, actually going out. Like, you want to get shit-faced drunk, and then you want to end up in a diner, McDonald's, you know, just some greasy-ass, horrible shit. woo! that's what she's doing tonight. Yeah. But yeah, my drunk munchies was McDonald's. That was my curse. And I loved waking up, like, early the next day, and you're like, oh, shit. Oh, I can't believe I ate all that shit. But you're not even talking about all the alcohol you consumed that night. In, like, reality, the food was a healthier choice than the alcohol that you drank. It's stupid decisions like that, man. was everybody laughing at the girl with the laugh? I heard that shit all night. Yeah. Good news, though, I did book her for the next show. So if you guys want to, you know, see her for the next show, we'll be here. Yo, is that real? Who is that? Who's laughing like that? I can't see you. Here? It's real?
Figure out.
Can you do that laugh? Yo, you're fucking with me, right? Holy shit. Fucking Ann Drescher. I haven't heard that laugh since Jack and Ben and fucking Robin Williams and Jack. That shit is ridiculous. I swear, yo, she's like, when we're backstage, right, we're in the green room, everybody who performs, they go up, like, you hear that fucking girl that's standing out there? She's getting more attention than this fucking show. That's all I'm doing. You go, girl. As long as you laugh, that's all I fucking care about. I got regrouped here. Speaking about, like, drunk bunches and shit like that, I heard Uber drivers, they're starting to give their drunk passengers, like, toys to play with to keep them occupied for their way home. And I heard the main thing was a Bop It. You guys remember the Bop It, like, in the 90s? Yeah. Okay, I'm sorry. I would love to hear drunk stories and the stupid shit that people did drunkly all night. Then I'm trying to drive home in peace. I'm completely sober. I hear, Bop It, squeeze it, pull it, twist it, Bop It, squeeze it, pull it, twist it, Bop It, man, fuck you! This is ending up with the last of my set. Did you guys enjoy yourself tonight? Everybody make some motherfucking noise if you want me to end my set on another dance. Sound guy, you know the deal. Hit that shit.
Thank you.